Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to be doing the video for the Ski-Doo OnePlus One seat with backrest on my 2016 Ski-Doo Blizzard. Stick around. All right, well, many of you have seen my 2016 Blizzard in my videos before, and you may have seen that too long ago, maybe a video or two ago, where I installed this bag. And so today is going to be where I'll take this off for a minute while we install the brackets for the backrest. The seat itself is not really an install. You just remove the old one, quick release, and slip the new one on. But for the backrest, you have to install some brackets, and that's what we're going to do here today. If you bought this used, someone else will be doing all this work for you. But at least I'm going to show you how this all goes together today. Let me show you the boxes that they are in right now. Okay, so there are two what appear to be identical boxes. In this one here, we have the seat kit. And in the other one over here, we have the backrest kit. Today's the day. We're gonna put it on because the season's about to start. We did get some snow out here, but it's warming up again. And next weekend is Snowdio in Old Forge. I'm gonna try to get out there. It's just a matter of coordinating things with my riding partners there. My brother can't go, he's working. And Gary can't go because he's about to have minor surgery and won't be able to ride until probably the second week of January. And so it looks like it'll be me and Shag at this point, and he's trying to coordinate that. All right, before we get started, I'm gonna take the bag off and the seat off. It's a real simple procedure, but I figure getting them out of the way is the best thing to do at this point. So that's removed. And then the seat, grab here, pull up on the lever, and that's it. And we'll just set these aside. So this box has the backrest in it because that's what we need to start with. The seat doesn't need any preparation. So we're just gonna open this up, see what's in the box. What's in the box? All right, so we've got one handle here, and these appear to be some handle guards. The other handle is here. It's funny how there's a lot more to a backrest than there is a seat. All right, hopefully we got a good view here. I don't know what's in this. Let's see. It's the first time I'm opening this box, so obviously. All right. Type of panel. There you go. Almost looks like a snow flap. All right, so put that aside. And then this is the actual backrest itself. You can see here. And on the back are the four mounting points for the handles. And this actually zips off if for any reason you needed to remove it. We have the directions here with a bag of hardware, and looks like these bolts have the thread lock on it already, so we won't have to put anything on these. We'll look at the directions and figure out what these are for. So here in this box, one side link bracket. If you bought this used, someone else would be doing all this work for you. But at least I'm gonna show you how this all goes together today. And just to show you here on the back, this is all cast aluminum. This is not cheap plastic. It's all cast aluminum. And this is obviously the other side. Believe it or not, I don't know if you can see that, made in Vietnam. I was not expecting that. All right, and we'll just open the box with the seat in it. Just while we're doing the unboxing, I guess. Even though there shouldn't be anything to this seat but a seat. And there's the seat. Flip it over. It's actually got the space in there if you wanted to put your manual in there. Because it comes on your regular seat right in this area. So there's the seat. And now we got to get started putting the backrest together. All right, let's take a look at what tools you're going to need to do this installation. You will need a drill. The impact driver is optional. This is the hardware that you will have with it, and here is a sample of each piece of hardware that is in the package, just one of each, just to show you here. And so the first small drill bit here is just a, like a 3/16 to pre-drill the tunnel. The next size up is a 10.5 millimeter or 13/32 to drill the tunnel. Then this third bit here is a 8 millimeter or 5/16 to drill the backrest arm caps. And then we have a center punch here, which I actually made myself when I was taking machine shop way back when. And then the last bit here is a 6.5 millimeter or 1/4 inch to drill the padlock hole in the backrest support. As far as wrenches go, it's 1/4 inch. I'm using a nut driver here, but you could use a 1/4 inch wrench or a flathead screwdriver, which will be for this little screw here. The head on this little screw is a 1/4 inch, so I'm going to be using this nut driver for it, but you could also just use a flathead screwdriver. Okay, and then we have the T30 Torx driver. We also have a T40 Torx driver. And then we have a 6 millimeter Allen socket. I just have an extension in case I need that, and my ratchet. And then these are just the standard wrenches, 13 millimeter wrench, 13 millimeter socket, 16 millimeter socket, and 16 millimeter wrench. Just an assortment. You use what you have and what's most convenient for you. Now, I'll show you which tool goes to which piece of hardware. The T30 Torx is for the shorter screw here. The T40 Torx is for the longer screw. The 6 millimeter Allen socket is for this cap screw. And I already showed you the 1/4 inch nut driver for that small black screw. Either 13 millimeter nut works with either the wrench or the socket. These are 13 millimeter. And then this one here, which will be pushing up through the tunnel from underneath, is the 16 millimeter. And then this last piece here goes on the handle in this area. And I'll show you that obviously when we get to it. So the brackets that go on the tunnel will already be attached to the backrest bracket, as you can see here. So we'll have to remove these to put them on the tunnel. So just undo the rubber and then flip the lever, and the bracket should slide right out. And just set your backrest handles assembly aside until we get to them a little bit later. All right, you can see right here, there's two markings, and there's also the other two on the other side. And then down lower on the tunnel, you will see another marking right there. Let's see if I can get a better angle of that. But you can see the little dimple right there. But it does come with a template that you can put down on your sled if your tunnel isn't pre-marked. All right, so I've gone ahead and cut out one of the templates just to illustrate how it goes. My tunnel's already pre-marked, so I'm not going to use this template. But if you didn't have a pre-marked tunnel, you would cut this out and try to match it up like that. I've gone and temporarily put the bracket in place, and then I've looked overhead here. Not sure if you can see inside these holes, but you can see that the pre-marked drill locations line up perfectly, and it does as well on the bottom. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and drill these top two holes with the 3/16 drill bit, your little pilot hole. And just be careful, because these little bits, if you put too much pressure, you can break the bit and also scratch your tunnel when it breaks. So just take it easy and try not to push down too far after you've drilled through, because you never know what's under there, heat exchanger and all that. So just take that all into consideration. And if you prefer, you could use a little lubrication on that too, but we're not doing any crazy drilling, so just figure keep it clean. All right, now we're going to step it up to the 10.5 millimeter or the 13/32 bit. All right, it's really important that you have the 10.5 millimeter or 13/32 drill bit to drill those holes, because the 3/8 is just too small, and reaming it out it takes quite a bit of effort. It's going to be just a little too small, so it's really imperative that you get the 13/32. All right, I've already drilled the pilot hole for the side of the tunnel. Let's open it up. And you have to put this little plastic piece in place before you mount the link bracket. So it should look something like that, and then you put the bracket on top. All right, so now we're gonna take the two small screws that use the T30 Torx with the two bolts from underneath that take the 16 millimeter socket and install the first bracket. All right, so I was just about to install the brackets, and notice there's two different size of these, so you have to use the longer one on the brackets that go on the tunnel. So let's see if we can get one screw started. Okay, got that started. I'm gonna do the other one, and then I will put my socket on from underneath. So at this point, we definitely need the wrench underneath, and from underneath you're going to need a 16 millimeter. Snug that up. Grab a scratcher. It's getting in my way. That's nice and snug. Now you can see I'm kind of holding the socket right above the screw, because if I was to hold it way out here, I could strip this, and I don't get very good control. I also don't need a lot of torque, so this keeps that bit in place. Put the one through the side here. All right, so we've got the one bracket installed, and we're just going to repeat that on the other side. I've already gone ahead and drilled the other side. Then we'll pick up as we assemble the backrest. All right, so I've got both brackets on, and then I put the two brackets that hold the backrest on in place so I can start to assemble the backrest onto these brackets. All right, so you're gonna need four of these Allen bolts and four washers to install the backrest onto the brackets. And it uses a 1/4 inch Allen wrench. I just happen to have a socket for ease and convenience. So let's see if we can get this in place. So we're gonna try to slip that in here. And then we will grab one bolt and one washer. And we'll start at the bottom here. Slip that through. And just make sure that you actually have the bolt started nice and clear before you start cranking it down with your wrench, because you could cross-thread it. So just do it a little bit by hand and you can feel that it's going in properly. All right, just gonna put one in on the other side here just to keep it stable. If it feels like it's starting to tighten too quickly, like you've barely started the threads and it's tight, back it up, it's cross-threading. Don't keep going. Should be pretty easy to turn. All right, put one of the uppers in. And I'm just lining them up. These aren't tight by any means at this point. Just getting them going. This one here took a couple tries before it started going in straight. Even though you can see it, it could still go in crooked. Bolt and washer. You can see right inside there that it's lining up. Now that I've got the upper part started, I went ahead and locked these up. Okay, so we're about to install the backrest cover here. It goes on the back. So if you look inside here, you'll see a little vein or whatever you want to call that. And it corresponds with this on the backrest, and that's the orientation that'll go on there. There's also little tabs on the top here too. So I'm gonna get this in there, and you have to pull this apart before you put these bolts in order to install that. So I'm gonna set the camera on the tripod and we're gonna put this in. I'm just going to show you the fitment here before we go and put the bolts back in, but the little clip is inside there and this should rest right on top, nice and flush like that. So we'll just put the two bolts in here and tighten them up. Of course, get them started by hand. All right, the next step is to put the hand grips together and we're pretty much done. All right, so we're gonna put a hand grip on each one of these. And it says if you are installing the heated hand grip kit, this is now the time to do that before you put these on. So I guess we're just going to slip it on here. Sure, a little heat would probably help. See if they'll just slide on by themselves. going to use a little heat gun on this on low, because you have to fold this end over in order to bolt it together. So put it on low. Gonna need more than that. That helped. There we go. So you gotta get it to look like that. They probably could have found a better way to do this, but it is what it is. Alright, so we're going to take one of these short Torx screws and this part here and assemble this. So that goes in there like that. And then we'll squeeze them together and put the Torx bit there. And then your T30 Torx and screw it together. And just snug it up. I don't have to go crazy here, it's just plastic. And we might, let's see if we have to roll that. Yep, there we go. Kind of stretched out a bit. I'm gonna heat it back up to see if it'll go back. That's about it. You know, I had to push it so hard down this way to try to clear, you know, the other end that, you know, maybe we could push it back up. So there we go. We'll do the same thing on the other one. All right, I've got both of these assembled, both grips on. This was probably the hardest part of the install. All right, so we're ready to put the handles on, and let me show you the hardware we're going to use for that. We need these two large bolts. I believe these are the ones with the Torx 40 bit, and then a washer on each one of those as well. So there's two for each handle, and then the two nuts, they're both nylon locking nuts. It's just that one has like this shoulder on it and one doesn't, and it looks like the one with the shoulder goes on the bottom. We're also going to need this cap. It's got two holes in it. If you have one with only one hole, you may have to drill the second hole. Something I just want to point out, the illustration and the directions shows this part to have one of these longer than the other, but I'm not finding that, and it shows the part that sticks out more. If this one just say stuck out to here, that one would go on top. So if you have one of these parts that has one shallower than the other, the one that's larger goes on top. So the illustration shows the washer to go on the inside here. Actually, it shows two on the bottom and nothing on the top, but since my parts weren't, you know, one bigger than the other, I'm going to put one on each bolt on the inside. So we'll put it in place and then line it up. I'm putting mine in the lower position. You could also put it in a higher position according to the directions, but I figure lower is going to be more stable for this installation, and that's the way I'd like to do it. Now you can see that there is just enough sticking out to put the two nylon locking nuts on. So I'm going to do that now. Okay, so we'll put the nylon locking nut with the shoulder on the bottom, and then the one without on the top. We'll grab our 14 millimeter socket or wrench, whatever you've got. Give it a nice snug. Even though this cast piece is threaded, you want to make sure to put these on because cast aluminum isn't as strong as cast steel and it could strip out. And if you're yanking on these handles here, you don't want them to strip out. So there you go. I'm going to repeat that on the other side and we're just about done. All right, so in the last step, you're going to remove the backrest from the mounts, tilt it back, or you can put it on a workbench, it doesn't really matter. You're going to take these panels and you're going to put them in place, and there are four screws. They are the shorter Torx screws that go in here, and then you just have to make sure that this little tab here is inserted properly so that you can use the little quarter inch headed screw. Goes in there and then it'll screw into the back plastic piece on the back of the backrest. So let's see if we can get this in place. The tab will be on the inside of this, but this part will be right there, like that. So that'll go in last, so let's get this part screwed in. So I'm going to start these by hand. So this screw actually goes in on an angle. And you might want to get this part installed before you put all these screws in, because it's going to be next to impossible to do afterwards. You'll have to remove all the screws again. So just make sure it's in the proper position. All right, so I've got both of the inner panels on, and all I have left to do is put the two screws that screw the inner panels to the back panel. I'm going to use my impact with that little quarter inch screw. That's one. And the last one. Now I feel like it should go up more, but I don't want to force it, because then with the temperature changes and things, it could end up cracking. So I'm just going to leave it where it wants to be and put this last screw in. And don't tighten it much. It's all plastic. All right, so here's the sled with no seat on it, no backrest, but all the hardware mounted. I'll show you that up close. All right, so don't forget to put these little pieces on the back before you install each bracket. Seat just slips right on, no problem. Let's go grab that backrest and put that on. Let's get one in. Another one in. Drop them down. Lock it. Strap it. And there's a shot with the Link tunnel bag on it as well. That's like a perfect match. It works perfectly. So that's the touring edition of the Blizzard, I guess you could say. All right, guys, I want to thank you for watching. That backrest can be a little tricky to assemble. Obviously, if you only have the seat, that just clips right in. But the backrest has quite a few pieces there to put together, and you really have to pay attention to make sure you do the steps in the proper order. So if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you like to leave a comment, please do down below. Check the links in the description. If you're interested in any of the products that I've used to make my videos or I've used in a video, you can find that down there in my Amazon affiliate page. And we'll see you in the next video. Take care.